Guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm making a video after a long time and it certainly feels good to be back. And I really can tell you that I am planning to make videos much more regularly on the channel, so you can expect motorsport content related to MotoGP and Formula 1 on a much more regular basis. I'd like to start off by saying a happy new year to everyone watching. I hope 2021 is much better than what 2020 was when it comes to your day-to-day life, when it comes to motorsport. We as spectators did enjoy the 2020 racing season, but we had to sit in the comfort and safety of our homes and enjoy it. I hope that in the coming year, we could actually be spectators at the circuit and we could enjoy the sport in a much more better manner. Number two, I'd like to say, guys, that I am going to upload videos on Instagram as well. I will be uploading them on IGTV. So, guys, if you're not following me on Insta, please make sure you go down to Insta and you follow me over there. My Insta page will be flashing on your screens right now. So, please, guys, go over there and follow me on Insta. That would be amazing. I also plan to post some reels, which are short videos that will give you, you know, tidbits of information, some quick results, or maybe something that you just need to know about what's going on in the sport, so that you can be up to date about everything and anything that's going on in the sport. So guys, I would like to get to the topic of this video, that is why I feel that the 2020 MotoGP season, from a spectator's point of view, has been one of the best MotoGP seasons that we have seen in the recent times. Yes, I know that as spectators, we were not allowed to go to the circuit because of the pandemic and we had to watch the entire season from our houses. But what a season it has been. Number one, massive congratulations to Johan Mir for winning the 2020 MotoGP World Championship and Suzuki as well. It was a great effort. The reason behind, I feel the main thing that he had which the others lacked a little was definitely consistency. When you know that there are racing points available at every single round, this man would go and take points at almost every single round, and he just accumulated points, and at the end of the season, the importance was just there. His consistency is one of the major reasons why he has won the MotoGP World Championship, and it just goes to show that you can't be someone who's just good in one race and, you know, slacking in the others. You have to be consistent, and consistency is going to get you the crown. Number two, we have had so many unpredictable events. As spectators, it is something that we crave. There was not one guy who was absolutely dominating at one point. There was not one guy or just one man who was running away with all the races and all. I'm not saying that's wrong or anything, but when it comes to a spectator's point of view, it is something that you actually really enjoy to watch. When you switch on your telly or whatever you're watching it on and you don't know what happens next, you want that as a spectator. That keeps a person hooked. That keeps the new fans hooked as well. We as the old fans would watch it anyways, but for the new people to stay hooked to the sport, MotoGP has given us some amazing entertainment this season, some really close fought races and some amazing victors. I mean, we have had 9 different race winners throughout the season. 9 different race winners. That is no joke. That is something that is very unpredictable. And that is something that the sport should have more of. I was really happy to see so many riders stepping up and winning. Another instance I would like to say is the satellite KTM rider Miguel Oliveira. When he took the top step, I certainly did not expect that. I certainly did not expect a satellite KTM to actually go there and take the top step. But that was some great racing by Miguel that day. And hats off to KTM, and also a silent appreciation to Danny Pedrosa, who has been the test rider for KTM, and he has been putting his heart out, as it is evident with how good the bike has been this season, with how good it has been and how amazingly the riders on both the bikes are doing. So kudos to them and congratulations to them as well. And Johan Mir, as usual, has proven that consistency is the key to winning the world championship. At the beginning of the season, I'll be honest with you, and I can also bet that most of the people were saying someone like a Marc Marquez or a Fabio Quartararo or an Andrea Dovizioso would run away with the championship, would win the championship. But we did not expect Johan Mir to do this. Hardly any people must have had their money on Johan Mir to actually go out and actually do what he did that he did. But that is the beauty of this season. We have gotten to see something that that is just amazing. Johan Mir, yes, don't get me wrong, Johan Mir was considered to be a contender, but he was considered to be a dark horse kind of that could just come out of nowhere and, you know, take it away. But when it comes to all these guys, we wanted the big, we were all betting on the big names, even Maverick Viñales, though he struggled, but people still thought that Maverick could go on and win the world championship. But that did not happen. And I'm so, so glad that this is the level of entertainment that we have gotten. And I hope that over the coming seasons, this is what we get. This is the amount of entertainment we get from every single race that we got. So guys, this was the first video explaining why I think that the 2020 MotoGP World Championship was one of the best seasons. If you liked what you saw, guys, please hit the like button. If you're still not subscribed to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. Ding the notification bell. And for more motorsport content, please come back when I upload the next video. See you soon. Bye-bye.